I am going to teach you about unitary method and percentage, which is the entirely new for this session. So let us start about unitary method and percentage. Before starting this, let's discuss about some basic property which are being very useful for our further study. So here we start from a topic which is known as ratio, and I hope that you have studied about ratio in your previous classes, where you become to know about the meaning of ratio as to be comparison. Okay, so that the exact meaning of ratio is comparison only. Comparison. Ratio indicates comparison, which means that we compare the objects. We compare two objects. Then we write them in mathematical form. They are known as ratio. Just suppose that if we have two quantities A and B, okay, and I ask you for compare them, then you will write them as a ratio A is to B. So that the ratio is denoted by A is to B and read as A is to B. Okay, which means that we compare A with B. So this is the ratio, and the meaning of ratio is comparison. And there is one most remarkable property of ratio is that we can only comparison those quantity which are in the same unit. Okay, if the quantity have different unit, then we cannot compare them. In order to compare them, we have to make their quantity to be same, then we can compare them. Just suppose that if I give you 20 rupees and 20 rupees to 500 paise. Here we have two quantities, that is 20 rupees and 500 paise. But here we can see that both quantity have the different unit, so we cannot compare them. We cannot establish the ratio between them. For this, we have to change the unit into the same. So here we can see that this is the rupee. So write it as it is and convert 500 paise into rupee. For this, we write 500 upon 100, and here we get this is equal to rupee 20 is equal to rupees 5. And now here we can see that the both quantity have the same unit, and here now we can compare that. Here we can see that 20 and 5, how much money do you have? Total 25 rupees. And here you divide this 25 rupees into two parts. In one part you put 20 rupees, and in the second part you have 5 rupees. That means in what ratio, then the question is arises from there, in what ratio did you divide the money? Then here you can see that 5 was 5 and 5 for 20. So here we have 4 is to 1, which means that you have divided 25 in the ratio 4:1, which means that if you have, just suppose that if I have 5 chocolates, then I keep 4 chocolates for myself and I'll give you 1 chocolate. Okay? If I have 5 chocolate and I want to divide it into 2 parts, then I'll give 4 chocolate for me and I'll give you 1 chocolate to you, then here you can get 4 + 1 = 5. Similarly, just suppose that if I have 25 chocolate and I want to divide this 25 chocolate in the ratio 4:1, then what we do? So think about this. First of all, I have only 5 chocolate, okay, and now I have 25 chocolate. So just tell me, 25, how much time than 5? How much time 25 is greater than 5? Then you will say that, sir, here we have 5 times of 5. Here we have 5 times of 5 chocolate. That means we have 25 chocolate. So here you can see that, first I have 5 chocolate. Now I have 25 chocolate, which means that in the second time I have 5 times more than first. So that the first time the ratio was 4:1 and now it will become the 5 times. So multiplied by 5 in the both sides, and hence you will get 20:5. Therefore I have divided 20 paise in 20 rupees into 20:5, which has been divided into the ratio 4:1. Okay, so this is the concept of ratio. That means we have to compare the quantity, and here we can compare only those quantity which have the same unit. If they have different unit, then we cannot establish the ratio between them. If we can change the unit into the same, then we can compare them. Okay, so this is the ratio. Now let's see some question on the ratio. Here we have to compare 7 days and 2 weeks, that in what ratio they have divided. So here we first change the unit. Here you can see that in the first quantity the unit is days, and in the second quantity we can see that the unit is week. So we cannot compare them until we change the unit to make them same. That's why here we write 7 days = 7 × 2 days. Because we know that in 1 week there are 7 days. So we write like this, and now here we get 7 days = 14 days. Okay, and here we get 7 × 7 = 14, and then we get 1:2, and hence we say that 7 days and 2 weeks are divided into the ratio 1:2, and here we say that 7 days and 2 weeks are divided in the ratio 1:2. Okay, I hope the ratio is clear to all. Now let us see the next, that is the proportion. The next topic is proportion. What is the meaning of proportion? The meaning of proportion is equality. As we write the whole number as equal, if we write we have two whole number 5 and 5. Then if we compare them, we see that they are equal. Okay? When we compare these two quantities, we write equal. Here we can write 5 liters and here I write 5000 milliliters. Okay? Then I say, please compare. Then you will write both are equal. Then you will say that, sir, both are equal because we know that 5000 ml is equal to 5 liter. Okay? But proportion represent the equality of ratios. Proportion represent the equality of ratio. How? Let's see. We have 4 quantity, or you can say that here we have 2 ratio. A is to B and the second is B is to C. Okay. Then here we can write A upon B and this can be written as B by C. And if A by B is equal to B by C. Here we can say that A upon B, B upon C are not the ratio. They are the fraction. They are the fraction. And if two fractions are equal, that is A upon B is equal to B upon C, then we say that the ratio A is to B if in the proportion of the ratio B is to C. Okay? If the fraction A by B is equal to B by C, then we say that the ratio A is to B is in the proportion of the ratio B is to C. This is the definition of proportion. And here the elements, the quantity which are outside, which quantity are outside? A and C. A and C are the outside element. That is why A and C are known as extreme, are known as extreme point, or you can only say extreme. Here A and C are extreme and B and so here I have to write this like this, C by D, then this will become C by D, and this will be also changed like C by D. And B and C, B and C, B and C are inside, that is they are near to proportion. That is why we can say that B and C are in the mid of the proportion, and hence they are known as B and C are known as mid. Mean, they are known as mean. Okay, they are known as mean. And one most important thing I would like to tell you that if A is to B is in the proportion of C is to D, that is, if A by B is equal to C by D, then apply here cross multiply and we get A multiplied by D is equal to B multiplied by C. Now just tell me, what are A and D? A and D are the extreme. A and D are the extreme. So we can say that product of extreme is equal to the product of mean. This is the property of the proportion. When two ratios are in the proportion, then we can write them A upon B is equal to C upon D, and it will be equal to AD is equal to BC, where AD is called the product of extreme and BC is known as the product of mean. So this is the definition of proportion and this is the concept of ratio. In the next video, we shall discuss about the unitary method of this chapter. Okay, till then, goodbye.